Well, hello there, YouTube, and welcome to January 18th, Kelly and I's 30th anniversary. We're getting out of here later than hell.
That's only because of you.
Wiping the side windows. I didn't get the windshield and stuff, as you can see, but okay, I'm wiping side windows out, and Kelly goes, it's 11:11.
What is that? What's 11:11?
That was obviously 2 minutes ago.
Yeah.
But how weird is that? We catch that all the time.
I know it.
It's so bizarre. So anyway, we're gonna head to Astoria, Oregon and goof around there. We'll talk more about that as we go along. But we're on a roll. We'll see ya.
Bye, everybody.
Bye. Look, motorcycles. That's a good sign. That's always a real good sign. Okay. On this day, at this time, 30 years ago, me and this little woman said, I do. 30 years ago, in Reno, Nevada.
It seems like, you know, like 10 years ago, maybe.
Yeah, it seems like about 10 years ago. It's crazy. Last night in the, or in today's video, but it'll be yesterday's video. But anyway, in yesterday's video, I said it was around noon. I could have swore Kelly said, no, it was 10:30. So that's why I said it was 9:30. I just got confused. And then when I was playing the video back and editing, I realized that she said, it was 12:30. So yeah, we're Pacific time, and where we got married was in Mountain time, which is just 1 hour ahead. So anyway, 30 years ago in 1 minute. It's crazy. See that highway going up the side of the mountain there? That's Highway 30. The old highway snaked across the top of the hill, which is a fan. That's the Oregon side, by the way. Fantastic sport bike road. I used to go bombing through that all the time when I lived over here. But Kelly's dad helped build that road. When they first moved up here.
Yeah, from Oregon.
Yeah.
He helped do the blasting.
Yeah, he
built the road.
Started out as a truck driver, and they asked him if he ever driven a semi truck.
Oh, sure.
Never even been in the seat of one before, you know. Look down, and here's this complicated multi-speed transmission, and off he went. And he goes, his first drive was with his boss. It never was with the guy that hired him, you know, the never so afraid in his life, but he worked it out. And then he moved on to you know, where they drill the holes and throw the dynamite down there and blast the side of the hill off. They asked him if he knew about, you know, explosives and stuff like that, and well, it was a promotion, he was gonna get paid more, and he goes, well, hell yeah, that's crazy. Now that's cool old school stuff right there.
Yeah, my daddy
pretty brave to say, yeah, I know about dynamite, could have blown his head off. Kelly and I used to come out to these little rest areas right here. My favorite one was this one on the top.
Yeah.
And back in those days, there wasn't that Jersey barrier, and when you got done at the rest area, you just pulled out and came down the hill. But, you know, with everything, they improve it for safety and whatnot, but here's looking out over Longview. It's literally like taking off in an airplane coming up this thing.
Right there.
Yep, that was our little parking spot.
Yeah.
So we were first dating. We come up here and park. that was funny. Wow, look at that old barn. That old boy is rough. That's a bald eagle right there. Is he landed in the tree? We're in the little town of Westport, Oregon. The little woman can't make it. She's gotta make a little potty break. And since she is, I think I'll take advantage of it and do the same. We have entered the little town of Astoria, Oregon. Right up one of these roads right in here is the Goonies.
Actually, house.
No, her house is past.
Oh, that's right.
But right up right up one of these roads up here is the Goonie house, yeah.
Sorry.
The Goonies. It's an old pilot boat. It's out here as a museum piece now. Oh, look, there's a Coast Guard boat moored outside the museum. This is the Maritime Museum.
They have the coolest stuff in here.
Yeah, this place is cool. Cool stuff. The Columbia River Maritime Museum. That's a big old impeller right there. It's amazing to think of that thing spinning around under the water, and that's, in the scheme of things, pretty damn small. Yeah. It's crazy. You try to, like, those links are just laying there, and you pick one of those things up. Holy moly, is that thing heavy. Pretty cool, though. That's the old Columbia light boat. It's basically a mobile lighthouse, for a lack of better terms. They used to do that, you know, before we had all the sophisticated radios and stuff that we do nowadays. As these things, you know, during fog and storms, whatever, they would go out and float in areas and be literally a mobile lighthouse. Pretty cool stuff, huh? But we're looking out over the Columbia here. The Pacific is on the other side of the Astoria Bridge. Well, here's a little bit of a close-up on the Columbia. That looks pretty cool, that flag sitting out there with the Astoria Bridge. That old ship out there in the background. Like I was saying earlier, these things get set out here and quarantined for a period of time. This goofball's in here playing hide and go seek from me in the museum.
You suck.
I think she was trying to sneak up on me or something. Oh. Well, looks like the rain is coming. I'm going to have to put my camera away. But that looks cool, the Astoria Bridge out there with the rain. But yeah, I'm going to have to put this away. We're going to go for a little tour on the Columbia out here, the light boat that we were talking about earlier. That's the entrance. Come down, the first thing you get into is a little galley down here. Kelly and I were talking. We think it's probably been about, oh, this is just like a, this isn't the kitchen. I was thinking it was the kitchen. But it's probably.
Back in the day.
Yeah. Click, click, look where people have stole the knobs off of it.
That's pathetic.
But it's probably been 10 years since we've taken a tour on this thing. That's that access thing into the kitchen.
Oh.
Yeah, there's the kitchen over there.
Oh, that's right.
That's a big name. Oh, it's moving too.
I know, I
got
the wishy wishy.
Yeah. Whoa, it is moving.
Yeah.
Must be a ship or something, or maybe that storm coming. But here's the little sleeping quarters. Isn't that cool? Got your own little. A little port window. There's some more sleeping quarters in another area. They're more like bunk beds. There's your little potty room there. Yeah, she is shaking about, isn't she? It's funny, you look out there and the Columbia seems all calm and you get in here and so.
You feel like you're going like this.
That's probably an old-fashioned fire extinguisher attached to that at some point. But gee, there's a little picture of a guy working this desk at some point. Here's some info on the old Galvin built. If you guys want to freeze the frame on this, there's the specs on her. Built in 1951. Well, it was on station for that period of time. Here's the galley. Look at the paneling. Of course, I shouldn't laugh to have paneling in my house. I wonder if that coffee machine still works. They probably have little meetings down here. Ship clubs or historian get-togethers or something. Is this that radio room? Yeah, it's locked. Check this thing out.
This is way cool.
I think they're using it as a base station or something now. Look at all this stuff in here. That's cool. Refrigerator is on lockdown. There's one of the fire extinguishers hanging there. Yeah. There was a picture. Oh, there it is right there. Of a guy cooking on that stove there. See, there's the port window. Right there. Another entrance downstairs. Those bunk beds. Lay down, take a nap. You might wake up feeling a little queasy after. Oh, I can barely fit through that. I think that's our way back out. Seems like there are some showers and stuff over here. Oh yeah, that's a big old bathroom in there. Another entrance downstairs. I think these are more bunk beds. Yep. So it looks like you could have a pretty decent crew in here. Plenty of room for a few fellers. Well, we're stuck down here. They shut the doors. We can't get out.
I'm gonna look up here. I don't want to climb a ladder.
Are you grab assing back there, woman? Too much glare, I can't hardly get anything out of that. There's the museum out there. Should we do the Titanic from the back? Lean out here. I can fly. You go flipping out over there, you meathead. Well, they said the rain was coming, and she's here. It was sprinkling before it. We went in the gift shop there, and it just full on started dumping. So, with the bridge in the background. This right here is Stephanie's restaurant. Stephanie's Cabin restaurant, to be precise.
I just call it Stephanie's.
Yeah.
But it was fine.
like I was saying earlier, you better come here hungry.
Yes.
Or you can walk out with a big old doggy bag. Yeah. You know how that goes. You know, you think, you go, ah, it's not that much more. I can finish that thing off. My seatbelt's doing weird. But anyway, we're going to go in there and have us something to eat. As soon as you come in, you get fish. That's the ones we're going to eat tonight.
Kelly likes the fish.
All right. So here we are in Stephanie's. I love these old-fashioned things, you know, with the bars up front. Cooks right there in the back. Just reminds me of older...
older restaurants.
Being a kid and whatnot. Got ourselves some mud, some water.
Yeah, we got coffee, water.
Yeah. I can smell like a grill still going. Oh man, she's gonna be a cold, dark, wet one going. Well, not so cold, it's gotta be in the 50s out here. Yeah, it's actually quite comfortable. Wow, that thing is like totally blue light. I guess it kind of looks that way.
Yeah, it's kind of
blue. See the screen?
Yeah, that's kind of how it looks. That bluish gray.
Well, we had our little dinner at Stephanie's place. That was very good. Kelly's Hansenberg was a little dry, but
it's all right.
I had this French.
It's a French onion.
French onion.
Prime
rib dip.
It looked really,
yeah.
Really good.
Man, it wasn't huge like they normally do, so I didn't have to roll myself out the door.
But it was really, really good.
Yeah.
Yeah, I
didn't
like that though.
Yeah. It was yummy. Oh, that was the other thing. We were going to stay here over the weekend, but we couldn't find anybody to house sit the mutts and the horses and all that stuff. So we decided to just make a day of it, so, which is okay.
Yeah.
Saves some money too.
Yeah. It's all good.
Yeah. All good. 30 years with this little woman. What's funny is, we've been coming here to Astoria for over 30 years.
Yeah. Holy crap.
Before we were married, we were coming here.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's crazy the things you see that have changed and things that haven't changed. It's weird. Astoria is just Astoria. It's been here a long time. A lot of these houses are like crazy old.
This is the coolest little town. Yeah. If you guys get a chance, you guys gotta come here. Especially like spring and summer, you know, just so it's not so, you know, rainy.
Yeah.
But if you get a chance to come here, it's a
cool place. Cruising to the little, well, we were cruising, caught a light though, to the little town of Clatskanie, Oregon. And Mama over here was sacked plumb out.
Mm-hmm.
She was out cold. I think she's still out cold.
Mm-hmm.
This is dropping off the hill here on Highway 30, heading back down into Longview. Looks pretty cool, huh? Kelly's over there sleep talking. Like coming in for a landing. Once again in the old farm and feed store.
Always in a farm and feed store.
Yeah. Gas and animal food.
Never ends.
It never ends for us.
It's like every couple of days.
Well, there you two. Make sure you're smiling. And
smiling.
She just starts laughing. Well, thank you guys very, very much for coming along with us on our, unfortunately, only one day in Astoria. We wanted to spend the night, and we're going to leave Sunday, but we decided to leave Monday and spend the night and be there Tuesday, but as I explained at the restaurant, we just couldn't work out the animal situation
somebody
thing
to
here.
Take care of them, so.
And Sophie, she's old, you know, she stays inside at night.
If it was summer, I could, you know,
you know, have everybody outside. Throw outside. I can't do that.
Yeah.
During the winter.
Many hours of dark and the coyotes are crazy. And Kelly just heard what sounded like a dog being murdered out there from a neighbor or something. So, I mean, there's cats out there.
And my Marley has been gone for a week.
Her orange tabby's been gone. So
just everybody cross your fingers. Yeah. He's just out there catting around.
Yeah.
Please.
There's a lot of wild cats around here. I think half of them came from us. The ones that the owls and the cats and the coyotes didn't get.
Yeah. So everybody...
Keep your fingers crossed. He was a really cool cat. I am not a cat fan at all, but that was a cool cat. I could actually touch him every once in a while. And for whatever reason, I wasn't allergic. I don't think he cleaned himself very well because it's the saliva that
makes it. And he was a short-haired cat.
Yeah.
And he is so loving.
Yeah.
So loving.
Yeah, he'd hug her around the neck. It's crazy. But... anyway, every second that we talk, we're going over 20 minutes tonight. So we're just going to...
Sorry, guys.
Think.
I don't want to make it too long for you guys and drive you crazy.
Oh, yeah. I thought for some reason you were saying sorry to me, but I'm talking to them. She don't talk to me. No, she
don't talk to him.
But anyway, we had a great time. It was a typical thing that we do, just very relaxing. Ended up spending hours inside the museum. They changed a bunch of stuff.
And still wasn't enough time.
Yeah. Had a great time.
We were trying to hurry, and it's like, you could spend days in there, I swear.
In the museum, there's this thing about the Peter Ardell shipwreck that's over on the Warrenton side. And we're talking about going out there as well, but we just ran out of daylight. You know, just for some reason we forgot, you know, if it's rainy or cloudy around 4 o'clock, it's too dark to do anything. So but it doesn't matter. We don't care. We had a fantastic time.
Yeah.
We're talking time. About in the times that she wasn't asleep on the way home.
Sorry. I go to sleep.
She goes out.
I cannot eat. I will go out.
Yeah. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed. I know it was a lot of stuff around the museum area, pretty much is what the whole vlog was, but that's pretty much most of what we did. We had spent a lot of time at the restaurant that we didn't vlog or anything. So,
We had a good time.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was a wonderful anniversary.
It was. She got another one of her little snow globe things that she loves.
I love them.
Yeah, it was one with seashell.
Oh, things. It is so pretty. I'll show you guys tomorrow.
Yeah.
I'll take pictures. Oh, I'm so excited.
Yeah.
I love it so much.
All right. So, anyway, again, I probably said it 3 times now. Thank you guys very much for coming along with us today on our 30th anniversary. Still hard to believe.
I know.
Still crazy.
Years.
It's like
crud. Our little minds just go.
Yeah.
I'm
in a flash.
I'm standing there at the chapel when we got married.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It's crazy. So we'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Maybe we'll talk about some of the stuff tomorrow in a more timely manner.
Time.
So we'll talk to you then. Thank
you
very much.
Have a good night.
Fourth time.
Sorry.
All right. Maybe
bye,
fifth.
Everybody.
We'll see ya. Bye-bye now.